Hey, New York City, don't miss your favorite E Street drummer, Max Weinberg, bringing his live show to Huntington, Long Island, one night only, Saturday, October 26th, at the Paramount. Tickets for Max Weinberg's Jukebox, on sale now, at Ticketmaster.com. More info at ParamountNY.com.
Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
And thank you, progressives around the country, for turning our lives completely upside down. Dominic Carter here with you. The number to reach me this hour, live, 646-720-0635. I cannot believe this. These nutty protesters that don't have a life, let's call it for what it is, they have become so emboldened, so bold. You may recall here in New York City, and this is happening around the country, just last weekend in Philadelphia, police responding, kids doing donuts with the teenagers, young adults, with the cars. The police respond. They jump on top of the police car, open the police car doors, trying to attack the officers. So the NYPD officer in New York City involved in the recent shooting, these emboldened, nutty protesters showed up at his home in Brooklyn in the middle of the night, demanding that he come out and threaten to burn down the house if he didn't come out. Now, we've had to beep a good part of what you're about to hear. It's utterly disgusting, and it's being tolerated.
We want justice! We want justice!
We want justice!
We want justice!
We want justice!
We see how you ran off the porch.
Come on!
I told you your is gonna be viral, right? You turn the lights out. We know you up there.
Yep.
We want justice!
We want justice!
We want justice! 12.
Those quote-unquote protesters should have been arrested on the spot by the NYPD. Why are they being allowed to walk around? Why are they allowed to engage in antics like this? 646-720-0635. Cardinal Dolan, disappointed Kamala Harris is skipping the Al Smith dinner. The Cardinal himself stating, we are not used to this. Wait until you hear the rest of what Cardinal Dolan has to say. What is going on with the administration of New York City Mayor Eric Adams? People, top officials are dropping like flies. The school's chancellor, David Banks, to step down. He's the latest one with this turmoil as it relates to the Adams administration, the embattled head of the country's, of the nation's largest school system, expected to step down as Adams contends with the leadership shakeup in the face of this ongoing federal investigation, but I should say plural investigations. The school's chancellor, David Banks, will retire. J.P. Morgan CEO Jamie Dimon calling it like it is, stating what we all know as it relates to the border, right? As it relates to the border. And Jamie Dimon appearing on CNBC declaring, if you don't control the borders, you are going to destroy our country. Listen to the CEO of J.P. Morgan.
We are screwing up tons of other things, including immigration, but life isn't either or. So, you know, you can't say, well, we'll do this and do that. You know, you're dealt the hand you're dealt, and you got to deal with it. And so we should be very clear about helping the lower income population. You know, no country, every country's got to control the borders, and we have to control the borders. And so so they're all important.
Would you take the deal that the Republicans have put on the table, though, which is we want this border immigration policy as we've laid out and then we'll fund the rest? Would you rather take that than neither?
I have not read that deal in total, but I probably would take it.
Yeah.
We have to control the borders. Yeah. We need more merit-based immigration. We need more seasonal immigration. We need more. We need DACA have a place here. We need a path to citizenship. If you do not control the borders, you are going to destroy our country. And so I think the people who think that somehow this is okay, so now they're, you know, they're sending the migrants into New York and stuff like that. So all of my super liberal friends, now they realize what a problem is. Did it have to be that?
No, it didn't have to be that, unfortunately, but it is. Folks, let's engage in this conversation. The lines are open, 646-720-0635. I want to divert. I'll come back to Vivek Ramaswamy. He's calling for a level playing field in the final days of this campaign. We'll come back to that in a second. But I want to put a spotlight right here, right now, on this situation with Sean Diddy Combs, the charges that he's facing. A woman surfaced today, well, technically yesterday, and her allegation is horrible, claiming that Diddy Combs and his head of security bound and violently raped her after drugging her. So the woman, Thayla Greaves, sobbed and said that she's happy that Diddy is behind bars. Press conference was Tuesday, announcing the legal action. So the woman is alleging that this happened in 2001. And that not only was she viciously reportedly attacked, apparently these two filmed this to show to friends. So she filed court papers today accusing Combs and his ex-head of security, Joseph Sherman, of raping her inside the Bad Boys record studio in Manhattan. According to what she says, you will hear her words in just a second. You have to listen carefully because she's very soft-spoken. She says the men lured her. She was 25 at the time and dating one of Combs' employees. That they lured her into a studio where they gave her a drink, apparently, based on what she says, that was likely laced with a drug that caused her to briefly lose consciousness, the lawsuit alleges. She says that she, quote, awoke to find herself bound and restrained before they brutally sexually abused her and violated her. She claims that she has never recovered and that her wounds were reopened in November of 2023 when she discovered her attackers had made a video that they showed to multiple men seeking to publicly degrade and humiliate not just her, but her boyfriend as well. She's had a rough time. This woman now lives in Texas. And she says the reason why she didn't report this depraved attack to police was out of fear that Combs would use his power as a hip hop industry kingmaker to, quote unquote, ruin her life. Listen to the woman as she tells her story and the impact that this has had on her.
The internal pain after being sexually assaulted has been incredibly deep and hard to put into words. It goes beyond just physical harm caused by and during the assault. It's a pain that reaches into your very core of who you are and leaving emotional scars that may never fully heal. Some of the hardest parts of this pain are the shame and the guilt I have experienced that plays a negative part in my day-to-day ability to function properly, being blamed, questioned, and threatened has often made me feel worthless, isolated, and sometimes responsible for what happened to me.
We'll let you hear a bit more of what she has to say later in the program, but I want to start with your telephone calls, 646-720-0635. That is Charlie, Bayside, Queens, line one. Charlie, what's on your mind?
Hi, Dominic. A pleasure. I usually call Frank, but I've been listening to you so much, I had to say something on this subject. Thank you for taking me. We got to get law enforcement back on our side. I was involved in a thing tonight down in Bayside near Fort Totten. A friend of mine had a little fender bender with these race car guys with their Subarus, with their loud mufflers. And he called me to call the police, and because he speaks little English. And they put me through such a rigmarole to try to get a patrol car down there. So it's almost like they don't want to get our backs. The citizens have no, I don't want to bash the cops, but this whole system with Adams, who doesn't back them, they really have their backs against the wall. They don't want to come out. They sit around and they watch people on Bell Boulevard. But when there's something going on, they're like, oh, you got to do better than that. You got to give us the exact address. I gave him as close to an address as I could, right? I gave him the name of the shopping center. My friend's down there being accosted by six or eight of these guys. He's an older man. And they never showed up. But on the other hand, I love them. I want law and order back in. We got to get better administration, better protection,
Charlie,
I really feel bad for her. And it's happening everywhere. My wife takes the train. She's a little girl. I'm scared every day. She's going to call me from the ER.
Charlie, I really feel your pain. It's a horrible situation where the police have been handcuffed, bad management at the top. Look at what's going on these days where in New York City, at least, the commissioner just stepped down, all of these federal raids and so on. And sometimes in society, Charlie, what I find is people want to protest for the sake of protesting and don't really understand what they're protesting about. So this is what I mean by this. You wanted to get rid of stop and frisk, which was a great law enforcement tool where police had to have probable cause and then they could search someone. So now you got rid of, and the allegation was that it's unfair to blacks and Latinos. Well, let's look at who's committing the crimes. First of all, a majority of the crimes. And let's look at the situation that we have now. So, Charlie, before I take this break, did the police ever respond?
No, nobody showed up.
It's very dangerous because people are being stabbed these days by these large groups. Go ahead quickly. Go ahead.
I had a golf club with me. That was all I had to help them. And I was afraid of getting shot if they did get into a ruckus.
Right.
But for some reason, they left. The weird part was my friend was at fault. He even admitted to the guy, I'm sorry, I'll call insurance. And they just started harassing them physically.
Right. They didn't want to call insurance because they have no insurance. Charlie, I've got to take a break. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Folks, I am coming right back. Stay with us.
This is Dominic Carter.
Larry Kudlow here with an urgent warning. Washington is coming for your savings to pay for their spending mistakes. That's why thousands of Americans are shielding their savings with gold. For a free 2024 gold guide that explains everything you need to know, please go to colonialmetalsgroup.com/Kudlow or just call 800-621-3908. That's 800-621-3908 for your free gold guide and learn if you qualify for up to $7,500 in free silver now.
Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
And let's go right back to the telephone calls. The number to reach us this morning, 646-720-0635. Russ, White Plains, New York. Russ, what's going on? What's on your mind?
Dominic, I'd like to know, do you think there's been a history of an exaggerated fear of black male sexuality? I mean, Sean Combs, these women know what's up. And now with Mark Robinson and Bill Cosby and Clarence Thomas, Hugh Hefner got away with all this stuff. And you can't tell me that it was only Harvey Weinstein at Hollywood parties. You know, I mean, you work with white men who were credibly accused of drugging and raping women, and they got away with it scot-free. You don't believe the FBI, do you?
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Russ,
I don't want to give you a headache, but, you know, that's how I feel.
Russ, where are you going with this? What? Russ, I don't get it the way that you think. What are you doing here? Where are you going with this? You're trying to put me on the spot to force me to answer some cocky mamie idea that you may have. But where are you going with this? What are you really trying to say? Let's try and work this out.
I'm not trying to put you on the spot. I just think there's been a history of an exaggerated fear of black male sexuality. You know, I mean, there is a history of this. And I just wonder if Sean Combs is the recent example, and certainly the FBI is messing with Donald Trump. They could be messing with Sean Combs, too. I and Mark Robinson, he's definitely the victim of a smear campaign. And you wonder why blacks don't help Jewish people.
Russ.
What?
Russ, come on. Do you have to go there all the time and get to the border of anti-Semitism? Do you have to do that?
Only because you have said, why don't black people support the genocide in Israel? And I'll tell you, it has to go both ways. And I think that attorney general, that sleazy guy down there in North Carolina, is pulled this rabbit out of a hat for Mark Robinson. I don't see any problem with him. He reminds me of Roy Innes. He seems like a very powerful man.
Have you seen some of the quotes attributed to Mark Robinson? He's denied it. Some of the things he said on social media. I mean, are you serious, Russ?
He said them in tongue-in-cheek, obviously, in context.
As the lieutenant governor of the state. Come on, Russ.
Yeah.
Russ, do you know why I played the woman's pain and anguish just a few minutes ago, and I'm going
to
do it again?
Well,
a different clip. Because of what this woman has gone through and her life. We don't ever want to say somebody's life is over, but she's in a tough situation. And you're calling me up to say basically that this is a fear of black male sexuality.
Yeah, I think a lot of people agree with me.
So rough gang sex on a woman, a group sex, if the allegation is true, and that's okay when she was drugged. Russ, come on, man. You're
Plato's
better
retreat.
Than this. Russ,
Plato's
Russ, come on, man. That's disgusting.
Plato's Retreat.
Let's kill his mic, please. Kill his phone line. You're better than that, Russ. Come on, man. Stop calling me with this nonsense. I'll be right back.
Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
In a moment, we're going to Joaquin in Pennsylvania. But first, the big Tunnel to Towers Foundation walk run is coming up this Sunday, September 29th. And all of us here at Red Apple Audio Networks are encouraging you, our loyal listeners, to donate to our individual teams. That's right. You can go to walk.dominiccartershow.com and click on my picture to donate. Please help me raise the most money for the amazing Tunnel to Towers Foundation Walk Run. Let's never forget America's heroes and what they do for us. The Tunnel to Towers is near and dear to me. Let's raise some money, please, for our veterans, for our first responders, and 9/11 victims. That's walk.dominiccartershow.com. Click on my picture to donate. Every dollar helps, and that is this Sunday. Joaquin in Pennsylvania, what's on your mind?
Hey, Dominic, you know, in answer to Rusty, I cannot believe this because that woman's story is so heartbreaking. You know what she went through? This
Agreed.
Was not somebody who, you know, I don't know where the heck he gets off with that one. But, you know, unfortunately, the way things are going right now, half this country has gone over a cliff. You know, they bought on to this New World globalist communist agenda. And this whole climate change, Green New Deal thing, that's becoming a religion. As a matter of fact, I heard today that they're starting a new green religion, you know, for climate change and to worship the earth. And, you know, you had a caller last night and he was talking about biblical end times prophecies being fulfilled. It's hard not to actually see that right now. And when you look at the situation of Israel in the Bible, it does say that in the end times, Israel will actually be abandoned. You know, the people will be gathered up together and brought back into the land that God gave them, and then they will find themselves alone against the world.
I don't see that happening, Israel being abandoned. That would be absolutely horrible, considering how much of an ally Israel has been to the United States of America. As far as Russ... You know, Joaquin, I don't know, man. I said, anybody that listens to this show knows that I give you plenty of rope to make your comments, to articulate yourself. But Russ, it's like, I don't know if he has a thing with punishment. He can go 2 or 3 days and be perfectly normal and then just completely go off the deep end like tonight. And I'm not gonna lie to you, Joaquin. Sometimes I do wonder what people look like, because if I could see people, sometimes there are some people that call the radio station, this station in particular, has a great voice, but I wonder what the individual looks like. And so what he just said, I didn't want his last comment to air, but the phone line was still open, and that's on me. The last thing of what he said, and I'm not going to repeat it, but it's disgusting when you consider what happened to this woman and what Russ was just saying. Final thought, Joaquin, before I move on.
All right. You know, as far as the country goes, though, we really, really, you know, people have to wake up and learn that we have to actually deport all the illegal immigrants, because, you know, whenever I hear people say, well, you know, you should vet them. No, we flooded the country with way too many people that we can't deal with. And this is being done, you know, to destroy the country, because there's going to be no money for Social Security, for Medicare, or anything. And I'm old enough. I'm going to be going out on it pretty soon myself. And the only possible hope is that the Trump economy comes back that actually makes money, drill, baby, drill, and we have a thriving petroleum industry. And then money winds up going back into the system. And then hopefully maybe Social Security can be saved.
Well, agreed. And thank you for the call, Joaquin. Agreed, because, you know, you have the vice president with her beautiful smile throughout the country promising this, who's going to be able to pay for this stuff? Who's going to be able to fund all this stuff? You and I know who the bill's going to come due to. You and I, and the country just doesn't have this type of money. And then when you add the migrant situation, you can't sustain this type of situation. The number to reach me right now live, 646-720-0635. So I mentioned the woman that came forward, the P. Diddy situation. She came forward to tell her story, and she did not file a police report when this allegedly happened, but she and many victims don't, out of shame, guilt, and she's telling a horrific story of being brutally raped by Sean Diddy Combs and his in a vicious way and his bodyguard. We're going to let you hear the second part of what she has to say in just a second. But let me go to Nick in Virginia. Nick, what's on your mind?
Hey, Dominic. I want to make a comment or two about New York City. It used to be my favorite place to go. You remember the old I Love New York t-shirts?
Yes.
You know, that were so popular. Every tourist bought one.
Yes.
Well, now you can redesign it and have a I with a big picture of your Mayor Adams, and then like a dollar bill or a heart broken or a piggy bank broke in half, and then New York at the bottom, because that's what it seems like to me. And my memories of New York is like Nat King Cole and the Lazy, Hazy, Crazy Days of Summer. That, you know, the old times, the good times. Now, I don't understand how anybody in that city can vote for Kamala Harris after all the stuff that has come down there over the past 4 years. I just don't understand what's going on in the heads of people in New York City.
Well, it's not just New York City, Nick. It's in urban areas around the country. It's with core Democratic voters that they really feel anything but Trump, anything and everything but Trump. It doesn't matter that we were doing better with Trump, all of us personally, financially, than with Biden. None of that is relevant. And you know, the sad thing about it, honestly, Nick, in some communities, what's the best way to say this? It's government handouts. So they don't care. Because whether it's a Republican giving them a handout or a Democrat giving them a handout, it's still a handout that you and I are paying for. And you and I know, Nick, in the real world, if we don't work, we don't eat. It's as simple as that. You know, sometimes we're ill. We get up and we go to work. It is what it is. Nick, thank you so much for the call. And from Virginia, let's go to Deborah, Fort Lee, New Jersey. Deborah, what's on
Hi,
your
Dominic.
Mind?
Dominic, I have a question. Maybe I didn't hear it correctly. Are they going to round up the other people that were involved, like the other guy in the video and the people, the accomplices of?
You know, Deborah, that's a great question. Before we went on the air this morning, that's a question that I was asking myself. So right. This woman, she didn't file a police report. So you right. can't round somebody up when there right. wasn't, you know, you don't have a witness, a victim here technically in this case. But yeah. but I don't know. It's a good question. But I guess okay. you're going to have to be able to identify these individuals, statute of okay. limitations and so on.
Okay. And I have another question. So if they have a video, they probably have the person in the video. Is that correct?
Well, it depends on which incident and which video. That's what's so sad about it. There are probably so many encounters that, you know, we have to be able to be specific about which one we're talking about. But go ahead.
So at the end of the day, as bad as he is or such, they're hiding him out. Maybe these other people will never be called into this. You know, they're sort of like an attacking procedure.
Your phone is going in and out, Deborah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. It's okay. It's not your fault.
Okay.
I was going to say you're not AT&T. Is AT&T? Yeah, they're still around. They're still around. I think the feds want Diddy. They want the big fish.
Him. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And they're going to get the big fish. I say to people all the time, Deborah, when the uh-huh. Southern District comes, don't waste your money mortgaging your house and all of that nonsense. Just cut a deal, the best deal you can, because 9 times out of 10, when the Southern District comes, why do you think they went after Menendez? Because, and you see they got him. When the Southern District comes, you're going down, and it's that simple. Yeah. Deborah, so we'll see what happens in this situation.
Okay. Tommy, if I have a question, I don't know if you remember, it was about a year ago. I don't remember the country, but that girl went on vacation with her friends and they beat her up on video. Do you remember that? That beautiful girl?
Oh,
look it up. And then the video surfaced that they were all in the room and beat her up. And then they told the mother that she got sick. She got food poisoning. And I just wonder if you can look into that. I wonder what happened with that case. And then the mother found out that they were all in the room and they beat her up and they all came back from the vacation. But again, well, there was a video. So whenever there's a video, it tells the truth.
I promise I will look at it. But you know, and thank you, Deborah, for the call. So I just got an email. I won't say the person's name. Folks, sometimes you can't win. And the person says, why isn't your radio show using the WABC phone number, which is the number we use for daytime? All right. Okay, so here's the honest answer. Online, you folks have been complaining and complaining and complaining that you can't get through to reach this show. So management decides to use this number that has many more phone lines, and there's a conspiracy as to why we're not using the other number. We could easily go back to that one, but it's less phone lines. We have done this, the entire team, to accommodate you folks to get many more calls coming in. Let's go to Benny in Bayside, Queens. Benny, what's on your mind?
Hey, Mr. Carter. Good evening, actually. Oh, good morning. Anyway, I happen to live in the 111th, and I happen to be friends with a lot of cops, a few cops. And the reason why they have body cams, not the reason why they have body cams, is to protect, you know, the citizen and everything else. They have a team of, the city has a team of council members that just review the tapes all day long. Their squad car cameras, everything. You know, oh, this guy rolled through a stop sign, you didn't pull him over. This guy, you know, rolled through the red light, boom, boom, boom. And they're just going after them viciously. And I never seen a city council so excited tell a police officer after 7-8 years, I'm sorry, your pension, everything you built up, bye-bye.
This is what happens, Benny. This is what happens when you elect a bunch of nut jobs to the city council. This is what happens.
It's very true. I have another point.
This is what happens when they go to the community. At these nut job elected officials, and they go, the man is keeping you down. We've got to stand up to the man. And then you get this. This is what you get.
But they're only after Republican areas of Staten Island. It's weird how they're only reviewing the cameras on the offices, what I heard through a few people. They're only after the cameras that are in Republican areas. Let's kick those guys off. It's amazing why 20,000 New Yorkers are leaving every year. You know, taxpaying New Yorkers are leaving every year.
These nut job council members could care less until they lose their Lulus and they can't fund their district office. And they never stop to think, if you keep running people away, who's going to be left to pay the bills? It's an absolute nightmare.
Because obviously the lady with 7 kids getting every handout, she's not the one leaving. She's staying.
Of course not.
But also, they're after the ghost plates. Oh, my God, what a nightmare. Stand on any bus stop in the Bronx and see how many people pay for the bus. That's not a problem, apparently. See how many people top the turnstile on the number 6 train. That's not a problem.
Yeah, the subway system. Benny, I got to wrap it up, my friend. You can call anytime, please. We can have this conversation. It's sad. It's sad. It's so bad. It's so bad with the subway system. And we're going to find out how it is in other cities. But it's so bad in New York City that when I do ride the train, I try my best from time to time because I need to know what's going on if I'm going to report on the system. And it's so bad, I feel like a fool paying the fare because almost everybody around me is going under, hopping over the top, kids, ladies, tourists, everybody's going under, everybody's squeezing through, nobody's paying. We've got to take a break. I am coming right back.
This is Dominic Carter. Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
And so I'm looking at my Twitter, at my ex, Dominic TV, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, Dominic TV. So YRN says here, we want the old phone number. It's a part of the show. This 646 number has no ring to it. No pun intended. So YRN, you need to know that you folks complain for months on my social media that you can never get through to me, that you're on hold, you're waiting for an hour, it's busy, you can't get through, you can't get through, you can't get through. So we devise a system that permits double the amount of phone calls because of the popularity of the show and the volume of the calls that's coming in, and now you don't want that. So we can't win for losing. We switched to a number to accommodate you folks, the listeners. Let's go to Susan, line two in New York. Susan, what's on your mind?
Hey, Dominic. You know, I caught yesterday afternoon that the topic came up of Harris when she was Attorney General, how she put in this plan to get money.
Wait, did you say Searle? I couldn't hear, Susan. I couldn't hear. Are you talking about Kamala Harris?
Yeah, Kamala Harris. Okay. And when she was Attorney General in California, and she was implementing a program to raise money by charging parents whose kids were truant.
Okay, what's the point you want to make? We've discussed this many times.
Okay, well, I haven't heard it.
Susan, we're short on time. What is the point you want to make?
Point is that people have to see the woman, the mother, that and what her story was. And it is easy to find online. Real clear politics.
Susan, we've played the mother. Thank you for the call, Susan. We've played the mother three or four times on this program. The same exact clip. Now, maybe you weren't listening that day, Susan, but we've talked about that incident and about parents in California where their kids were absent. The state attorney general, then Kamala Harris, went after them. Several were jailed. Many were arrested, put in jail, lost their apartments, lost everything. We've talked about this about five or six times. I do want to circle back. I want to circle back to Cardinal Timothy Dolan, the Archbishop of New York, expressing disappointment that Kamala Harris intends to skip the upcoming 79th annual White Tie Alfred E. Smith Memorial Foundation dinner this year. The Cardinal declaring, we're not used to this. We don't know how to handle this. This hasn't happened in 40 years since Walter Mondale turned down the invitation. And remember, he lost 49 out of 50 states. This is the Cardinal talking. I don't want to say there is a direct connection there. So we'll see how that plays out. I can't play the full statement of the woman with the P. Diddy part, but we're going to the which she alleges she was raped by him and his security. We'll let you hear as much as we can before we have to close out this show.
I go through spells of being distant and withdrawn that it's sometimes so hard to leave my house. The trauma of the assault has taken a toll on my mental health. I've had PTSD, depression, and anxiety. I'm emotionally scarred. It has been hard for me to trust others, to form healthy relationships, or even feel safe in my own skin. Flashbacks, nightmares,
and that's just one of the alleged victims. I'm back 3 to 4 p.m. and 23 hours from now, folks.